Society's approach to automation requires delicacy. The automated tools can be captivating to watch in action. The process can spare workers immeasurable injury and danger. And automation is no small part of why worker productivity rose roughly 70% from 1993 to 2011. Yet you probably didn't hear the pervasive stat that automation cost the US manufacturing sector millions of jobs from us first. There are a number of reports that over the next 10 years, the number of lost jobs could climb to an economically devastating 73 million or so. Now, on the other hand, there are groups such as the Economic Forum that forecast how automation will create tens of millions more jobs than it wipes out. However, the gains and losses end up balancing out. The economically viable implementation of automation is still one of the most significant challenges facing society. Number 10. Einride Coca-Cola. Much of the attention regarding automation fear has been focused on the fate of commercial truck drivers. There are roughly 1.8 million livelihoods and $125 billion annually at stake. Since Uber's first success with automated vehicles in 2016, it seemed like only a matter of time. An event in Sweden might just have been the long-anticipated sign that the time has arrived. In December 2019, Coca-Cola European Partnership and the food retailer Axfood announced they would use the autonomous electric transports by the then three-year-old company Einride to haul freight between their warehouses in the Stockholm area. Reportedly, these vehicles can haul loads of 26 tons and have a range of roughly 124 miles. Fortunately, this doesn't represent a direct threat to employment rates at the moment, as the vehicles still have human drivers that can remotely control them if needed. Number 9. Skyline Robotics. The washing of windows on a high-rise building certainly looks dangerous, but the process has been perfected to a point where, by 2014, an average of only one window washer died on the job in America every year. But that's one death too many, and from a business perspective, it's still a job that has such a high turnover that the washers demand high wages. The median is about $27 per hour for an experienced washer, though. Thus, the Israeli company Skyline Robotics rolled out a new machine in early 2019 that kept humans from having to go out on the scaffolding. Window washing robots released by Skyline don't use any chemicals, and they just use water with the minerals filtered out. Skyline has addressed concerns that it will drive people out of work by hiring the window washers, whose careers were threatened, and they now oversee the robots. The profit potential of this form of automation has surprisingly been fairly limited, only reducing the costs by roughly 10%. But when there is money to be saved, innovation follows. Number 8. Walmart. In March 2018, it was reported that Walmart was testing robots in 50 of its stores. Their main purpose was scanning the shelves for inventory 3 times per day. For optimal scanning results, the robots were over 6 feet tall. This led to a concern by the manufacturer that the robots would need to be designed to appear friendly, including affixing extra lights to them. However, the biggest problem seems to be that teenagers like messing with them. The success of the experiment seemed to be born out of the fact that in April 2019, CNN reported Walmart would be massively expanding the program. The 50 stores that used the shelf-scanning robots would be expanded to 350, while robot janitors would be expanded to 1,860 stores. All the while, Walmart reassured their employees that the robots were meant to ease their burden instead of replacing them, leaving the employees with more time to interact with customers instead of performing strenuous, repetitive tasks. If it turns out that reducing employee headcount is actually the goal, then if customers and employees pushed back and convinced management to remove robots, it wouldn't be the first time in retail that commerce stopped the march of technology. For example, IKEA and CVS both removed self-checkout kiosks from their stores over layoff backlash. Number 7. Heliograf. An employee doesn't need to work in a blue-collar or service industry for their job to potentially be replaceable with automation. In 2016, the Washington Post had an artificial intelligence program called Heliograf churn out 300 articles on the Rio de Janeiro Olympics. By September 2017, it had produced 850 articles. That's not to say it was an overwhelming success by online standards. The hundreds of articles collectively brought the Washington Post about 500,000 views. But considering that they were generated without any human effort, it was still a bargain. Heliograf now has a bit of competition. As of February 2019, Forbes has Bertie, Bloomberg Magazine has Cyborg, and there are many other examples. As of July 2019, the practice has been noted as spreading to Chinese news sources. Number 6. Spyce. According to a study released by CareerCast in 2015, being a line cook is the third worst job in America on the basis of pay rate, advancement opportunities, hours, and physical strain. So despite the desperation that drives most people to take that job, the temptation to automate it is understandable. One of the highest profile recent attempts closed for remodeling in Boston on November 22, 2019, with plans to expand along the East Coast. As shown in Spyce's videos, the automated cooks largely are tumblers into which custom amounts of ingredients are dropped, allowing for the food to be cooked more evenly by rotating it the entire time. Servers take over to deliver the food to customers, but really, how long before that's replaced as well? Number 5. Self-flying Airtaxi. With the growing proliferation of remote-controlled drone aircraft in militaries around the world, it was only a matter of time before the technology was applied to passenger travel. There is already a looming pilot shortage. Between the number of pilots that are aging into mandatory retirement and the high cost of getting enough training to become a licensed commercial pilot, which in 2013 went from requiring 250 hours to 1,500 in response to a particularly bad crash near Buffalo, New York. The technology here has also advanced far into the prototype stage. On January 23, 2019, Boeing announced that an experimental autonomous passenger aircraft had completed a successful test. Not only had the vessel been entirely electric, it was capable of straight vertical takeoff, which was especially impressive for an object 30 feet in length with a 28-foot wingspan. Its maximum flight range is 50 miles. Boeing did not discuss its maximum load capacity, but did mention that another prototype was capable of lifting a 500-pound load. Unfortunately, if you followed the news during 2019, you know Boeing's reputation has been severely tarnished. Less than 2 months after the successful test of the electric autonomous flying vehicle, the production of the Boeing 737 was halted because of a pair of crashes, and in a two-day period alone, Boeing's market value dropped by $11 billion. Any implementation of new flight technology by Boeing will surely be extremely cautious, at the very least. Number 4. Colossus. Speaking of high-profile disasters in 2019, on April 15th, Paris's famous Notre-Dame Cathedral caught fire. The cathedral's roof and one of the spires were destroyed, and the stone walls were severely damaged. Even by December, the damage was still too severe to hold Christmas Mass in the building. Still, there was a new technology rolled out that saved the building from total ruin and prevented the fire from spreading to neighboring buildings, while also ensuring that a single firefighter wasn't killed or injured. The Colossus is a roughly half-ton, despite being only 2 feet tall, tread-mounted robot that's part of the Thermite product line for How and How Technologies. It's so powerful that it can haul another 1,000 pounds of gear for a maximum of 5 to 6 hours, though its maximum speed is only 2.2 miles per hour. It wasn't exactly a pioneer, as similar robots have been used in China since 2017. Still, considering that these robots cost as much as $310,000 each, it'll be a while before often cash-strapped firefighting services will be able to replace humans with them en masse. Number 3. Cape Police's Drone Surveillance. Those who are worried that the US lives in a surveillance state won't be reassured by this entry at all. On February 18, 2019, it was reported that San Diego, California was using drone surveillance for law enforcement. By that point, the drones had assisted in 21 arrests, averaging approximately an arrest for every 4 hours of flight time. And these haven't just been for petty crimes either. It also includes charges for things like vehicular assault. Considering that it's limited to a flying 1 mile radius from its headquarters in Chula Vista, it just goes to show how much crime the operation could potentially record. As with Colossus, despite the success of the San Diego police drone program, it's not the first of its kind. That was probably in Wisconsin in 2016. Number 2. SRI International Go-Between. While drones are used for relatively long-range surveillance, there's the issue of how well automation will function for law enforcement when direct confrontation with a suspect is required. In May 2019, the nonprofit SRI International announced it was testing robots to perform routine traffic stops. It's remotely used to address the pulled-over driver, and its functions include printing up and extending a rod to drop tickets into vehicles. If the suspect tries to drive away during the procedure, the robot has spikes that it can drop to disable the tires. You might think that for a job requiring confrontations with dangerous criminals, that the current design looks much too non-intimidating to be of any use. You have to consider that, in truth, the most dangerous job in law enforcement is traffic work, and that stress and depression are far more dangerous for officers than direct confrontations with suspects. Even if patrol robots can only be made to deal with the most safe and routine traffic enforcement, their ability to keep officers out of risky traffic environments and cut down on their stress means they do have the potential to save many lives. Number 1. Military. The military has been using robots for bomb disposal since at least 2000, most prominently during the Iraq War. But what about using robots instead of soldiers on the ground? The closest this has come to reality so far was reported on October 7, 2019 by Science Daily. A factory in Pennsylvania tested humanoid robots for effectiveness in clearing out traffic impediments and searching objects, such as performing bag checks. 10 years in development, the robots were designed to be able to identify targets, such as tree limbs, without needing direct input. The prototype is still able to receive vocal inputs to better deal with complex situations, while it keeps human soldiers out of harm's way. As for automation with lethal capacity goes, in September 2019, the Norwegian arms contractor Kongsberg claimed that it had created an unmanned anti-tank rocket launcher by combining the Estonian Themis remote robot with American Javelin missiles. It is still human-operated, but it has independent sensors, and Kongsberg claims that it is trying to automate out the need for a human to operate and fire it. Really, though, this raises the question of, do we really want the robots being the ones deciding when to fire? So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below. Don't forget to subscribe. Also, I've got another channel called Geographics. I'm going to link to that below. Check it out if you are so inclined. It's all about geography. And thank you for watching.